lot of weird shows. Something has to be said about these people who claim to talk to dead people. I mean, that whole thing. They're always doing it in front of a group, which just shoots their odds right through the roof. Did anyone here lose a friend or family member? Or know someone who did? Or hear about something like this on television? You did, in the mezzanine. Yes, I was getting a strong signal. This person passed on recently, 25 years ago. That recently! I'm getting an M, the letter M. His name was Bo Ziffer. Mr. Bo Ziffer? He died of natural causes, yes? He was shot in the face by a bazooka, so naturally he'd be dead.
It's a heartache, nothing but a heartache. Hits you when it's too late, hits you when you're down. It's a fool's game, nothing but a fool's game. Standing in the cold rain, feeling like a clown. It's a heartache, nothing but a heartache. Love him till your arms break, then he lets you die.
Morning at 7:08 at WRJN Radio, Hometown Radio, where France Sergeant Kristi Wilcox from the Racine PD, Racine Police Department, is here. Thanks for joining us again.
Thanks for having me.
Good, 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 good. Glad to have you here. Do you have to be out of here at a certain time?
Nope.
Okay, good. She'll be here till noon today. Before we get into Love Week and everything, I was telling her, I watch all these police shows on TV. I watch On Patrol Live. I watch all these police videos. Because it makes my life seem so much better when I see how miserable other people are with their lives. And every time they pull over a car on Patrol Live, they seem not to have... First of all, they always have guns and drugs in their cars. Even if they pull them over for... if I had drugs and guns in my car, I wouldn't speed. And make sure all my headlights and taillights work on the car. Because they always get pulled over for these things that have nothing to do with what they eventually get arrested for. Also, nobody seems to have a driver's license that's valid anymore. They don't have insurance, and they don't have a registration that's valid. Am I the only person who walks around in my wallet with everything? And when you stop them, when they get stopped, they can't find anything. They're going through their glove compartment, and they have old insurance certificates from 6 years ago in there. I mean, do people really not take care of their business when they're driving a car?
No. A lot, many don't. There are some that do, and those are...
That's me.
Very, us police officers are very appreciative of those people, but no, there's a lot that don't.
And here's the thing, too. I always love it on these shows when they pull somebody over. Now, they passed a red light. They were weaving all over the road. Then they get stopped, and they say, what did I do? I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't do anything wrong. Then they won't get out of the car, and they start fighting with the cops. Some of these police officers have the patience of Job. I don't know how they do it. I don't know. I would be screaming at these people. I'd just tase them right away. I wouldn't even bother with all the niceties of, can you please get out of the car?
Well, that's frowned upon these days.
Yeah, well, that's why I wouldn't be working.
Lawsuits galore.
That's why I'd be sued. The other thing is, I like when people, do you know who I am? I mean, that's going to work. First of all, if I was a council member, there was one council, I wouldn't want people to know I'm a council member who just got pulled over and arrested. The last thing I do is say, do you know who I am? I try to hide my identity. And my wife used to work for the police department. She used to be a dispatcher, and used to call her in, check this ID. Nobody by that name. Check it again. Another one. nobody by that name. Three times you're out, and they bring you in. Don't people know that if you give a fake name, you're going to get caught? I mean, don't they? Are people that stupid? And you're going to say, now you won't say it on the air, but yes, people are that stupid. All right, we've got something going on. It's called Love Week. This reminds me of the 1960s when we had love-ins. Everybody with peace, love, everybody with flower power. Here you go. We're going to, there's just love in the world. And so what is Love Week?
Love Week is the brainchild of Officer Travis Brady. He's one of our community-oriented policing officers of our COP unit. And he thought, this is our second annual Love Week. So he came up with the idea that there's people in schools, whether you're a teacher, a janitor, a teacher's aide, someone in the lunchroom that embodies love. And they're always positive. They're always showing love to everybody. And he thought they needed to be recognized. So Love Week. So for the next 3 days, starting tomorrow, we will be going to every school in Racine Unified. So this includes even the ones now that aren't within the city. And we have a presentation for them. They get presented a certificate from the police department. They'll get flowers from Unified. Educators has partnered with us this year where they've bought $100 gift cards to Sebastian's for each recipient of Love Week. And I believe Haribo also has candy. They're yummy gummy bears that each recipient of Love Week will get. And it's all a big surprise to the recipient. They don't know that they've been nominated or voted for.
But who nominates them?
Each school nominates their own person. So I don't know if it's a poll that they take amongst teachers or how they're actually chosen, but each school has their own way of nominating.
And this is middle, high school, and grammar school?
Correct. And central office. Central office gets one, too.
Oh, wow. Yep. Look at that. Yep. He just show up unannounced?
Unannounced. Like, it's planned. Like, there are some people know that we're coming. Some have a whole school assembly planned for it where it's a big surprise. Some it's just within their classrooms or a meeting or however it is. But, yes.
That's nice that people think enough of you to nominate you for something like that.
Yep. Yeah, absolutely.
You know, I told the story on the air. I think I did anyway. The National Honor Society in high school, my grades were so-so. They were okay. They weren't great. But in our high school, we had the H track, which is the honor track. Gifted people were in that track. By the way, later in life, they weren't that gifted. But in high school, they were gifted. I mean, I've seen some of these people. I've seen their rap sheets. They're not that gifted. Anyway, they were the gifted people. Then you had A-track. These were the exceptional kids. Then you had the B-track with the average kids. And the C-track. These are the people that slept through school, didn't show up for class. They were in the C-track. Yep. That was the lowest you can be. I was in the B-track. My grades were okay. They weren't anything to scream about. And at the National Honor Society meeting, you know, in the assembly, I was copying a vocabulary book because I didn't do my homework. So I had my kid next to me, I took his words are important book and I had mine, I was copying them. And they were calling off all the students to come up on stage, again, the National Honor Society. And I said, I'm copying the book here. And they said, Rosen, they called your name. Hey, Rosen, the kid in the back of me wrapped me on the back of the head with a book and said, they called your name, get up there. So here I am walking up with the two books, the one I'm copying out of and mine. I walk up, they give me a candle to hold. I look back, I see all these kids laughing. They were sitting around me. I said, oh my goodness, they're going to be one candle short. The principal's going to say, Rosen, what are you doing up here with all these gifted kids? What are you doing? Lights came on. I saw my parents in the back. So I was in there. Aww. Years later, I went back to the school. And my high school's not there anymore. But when it was there, I said, how did I get into the National Honor Society? And she said, one student could be nominated. And all the teachers nominated you.
Aww,
even though your
sweet
grades didn't make. Yeah, so I know how good it feels to be nominated.
Yep.
You know, I got in through personality instead of, you know, grades, which is okay. But yeah, when you're nominated for something, it gives you a feeling that this is what people think of me.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you go through life, you say, well, you know, I'm okay. I do okay and I'm nice to people. But when people recognize you, that's good. So how many people are you going to visit?
Let's see. The schedule is jam-packed starting.
Hold on. She's doing the calculator.
Which yeah, let's see. One,
carry two. The 12, carry the 2, multiply, square root. See, I got this going on here. Hold on. Carry the 6. Let's see. That's
30? around 30.
Whoa.
Yeah. Yeah, it's jam-packed. Every 45 minutes, we move to another school.
Wow. I didn't realize it was that many. That's very nice.
Yes.
Well, there's going to be a lot of people surprised.
Very much so.
And they don't know it's coming. That's
they do not know.
Now, do you film it or anything?
I will take, I mean, because since I'm the PIO, I go and take pictures. Some of it I'll film, like, during the big assemblies, because there are schools that have assemblies planned for it. So it was a big success last year. It seemed to be very well received. So that's fantastic.
Yeah, you know, that's such a nice thing to do.
Yeah, it's fabulous. It was really heartwarming.
How do you also have days where you go in and talk to kids when the police go in? Because you don't want kids to be afraid of police officers.
Yes.
You know, Sometimes they see on TV, they see bad things happening, and they're afraid of cops, and they don't want cops near them. You have to go in there and kind of re-educate them.
Yep. Yeah, we go in. We have different stuff. A lot of times, it depends kind of on the schools, if they have certain topics they want us to talk on. I know last year, Wadowitz had a reading program where they were trying to get as many kids to read and log their hours. And then there was a prize at the end. And so officers would go in and read to the classes a lot of times, too. So there was a schedule for that. And so, yeah, we try and get involved with the schools, with programs. I know.
You have a drug talk?
If they ask us to have a drug talk, I don't think there's anything specific that we do on a regular basis, but.
Yeah, we had that in our school. We had the police come in and they brought samples of what we were not supposed to, you know, what to see, what
marijuana looks like.
Yeah, it was back in the 60s, marijuana cigarettes look like and all that kind of stuff. And they told us about heroin and all these drugs and scared everybody in the classroom.
Yeah.
Some kids weren't scared, some were. I've never had a cigarette in my life to this point. It really scared me. I didn't want anything near that stuff. But that's good when you get out there and, you know, you got to get them when they're early.
Yes, very much so.
Because they're corrupted real fast. You know, they're out there in the world and friends are corrupting them and just try this and try this. I remember the kids when I was growing up. We had a bunch of kids. I still remember their names, too. They would go after school, go a block away and start smoking. They said, yeah, I don't want to smoke. First of all, I don't like the way it smells. I'm sure I wouldn't like the way it tastes. So I never picked up a cigarette in my life. But, you know, a lot of kids did. And they were sorry they did because I'm looking now and they're not doing well health-wise. And, you know, I wish they could change it now. Sergeant Kristi Wilcox is here. Racine Police Department. We're talking with her. More coming up in just a moment. Stay right where you are. This is 1400 AM, remember I am, 1400 AM, 99.9 FM, 98.1 FM, WRJN, Hometown Radio, refreshed, it's 719. Kristi was telling me that last year it was freezing cold when you did this?
Freezing cold, yes. Last year it was Valentine's week that we did this.
52 today, 59 tomorrow. I was saying the meteorologists who we got this from couldn't bring themselves to say 60. They say 59, because you're only getting their hopes up. If we say 60, they're not going to walk out with winter coats. They're going to go spring coats. We're talking about schools and so forth. I think all my teachers are no longer with us, but Our principal was a guy named Mr. Dodd, Lawrence Dodd. He was a tall guy, very tall, very nice guy, soft-spoken, very great principal. I had him in grammar school. About 10, 12 years ago, maybe a little longer than that, I called the school and I said, how do I get in touch with Mr. Dodd? And they're very, you know, they don't want to give out that information. I said, I was there from, you know, all the years I went to grammar school at that school. And I said, he was my principal. I'd like to touch hands with him again, you know, get touched up with him again there. And they said, okay, he's living in Pennsylvania with his daughter. I'll give you his phone number. And I spoke to Mr. Dodd. This guy, I'll tell you something about teachers. They remember everything. Yep. Mr. Dodd not only remembered me, and this is, I mean, I left that school in 1966, and here we are in the 2000s. He remembered my name, remembered my parents' name, remembered my brother's name.
Wow.
I'll tell you something else he remembered. I was the crossing guard monitor, and I was the captain of the monitors. So I had to go out there first and make sure everybody was at the street corners surrounding the school. I had to do a walk around. We just put a new addition onto the school, and the banisters were nice and shiny. And you know what you do with shiny banisters? You slide down them. So I'm sliding down the banister from the second floor to the first floor, and Mr. Dodd is at the bottom. And you can't stop. Once you started, you're committed to going the full length. I said, oh, no. And I couldn't stop. And I get to the bottom, and he's like 6'6", and he's looking at me. He says, Donald, I think you're late for your monitor's post, aren't you? But he remembered me sliding down the banister. He said, yes, I remember that day. You were a crossing guard. And this principal must have seen thousands of kids come through that school, but he never forgot. Isn't that something?
That's something.
So we became pen pals, and we wrote. And then he moved to with another daughter after a while. And then he passed away. But I have the letters, and I said, I am so glad I kept in touch. And maybe you should keep in touch with your teachers. I have some of my high school teachers on Facebook, but all my grammar school teachers are long gone. But I remember them. I can remember all the kids I went to school with. One of the kids was Jerry Seinfeld, was in my kindergarten class.
Oh.
So I remember him, of course, remember him, but I remember all the faces of all these kids. And I'm so glad you're doing that with the schools.
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's really heartwarming.
Have anything else coming up?
Let's see. I can't think of anything off the top of my head. I know
No ticket week where you know it's going to get a ticket. Anything to do with that?
No, I don't think we run anything like
no
that.
No ticket week. No warrant week. If you have warrants, we're ripping them up this week.
No.
Now, do you have a lot of stuff like that in Racine where you have to serve warrants and do that kind of stuff? I see that all in the bigger cities, but Do you have a lot of that kind of stuff going on in Racine?
No. I mean, we don't have any specific groups that serve warrants or anything. A lot of it is if they get stopped for something or we have some sort of interaction with the person and we run their name out and they come back with a warrant. Typically, that's how the warrants get served.
Now, I was telling you before we went on the air, I don't have the story with me. I was trying to look it up. This woman had over 600 warrants,
that's
outstanding
crazy.
Warrants. 300 of them were felony warrants. The rest were misdemeanor warrants. How does she get away with that so long? I mean, how do you avoid these felony warrants? You figure they want to serve those. Now, I don't know if they were all in Wisconsin. I don't know where they were.
Right.
I don't know where they were located. But still.
Well, and you don't know if she used the same name.
How do people live lives like that? I couldn't do that. I was telling you that once I get my sticker for my license plate, if I'm off by one day putting that on my plate, I'm going down dark alleys, I'm going down side streets, I don't want anybody to see it. So that's the kind of life I live. I never drop litter on the ground. I never do any of that stuff. I just don't want to get in trouble. I know people that got in trouble. A lot of my high school kids got in trouble and so forth, and I don't want to get in trouble. So I avoid that. I don't make eye contact with police officers. I don't, if I see a car, I turn the other way. But isn't that much crime in Racine?
It depends.
Yeah.
It ebbs and flows.
Yeah.
We're doing good right now.
Now, the cop houses.
Yes.
What are those?
Our COP houses are houses within certain communities that are underserved. And those houses bring programs to each of those neighborhoods. It puts a face, a friendly face in there, or which I hope is a friendly face with the officers, that allows people to go and meet and greet the officers. They have programs. A lot of them have food pantries out of their COP houses.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Some have game nights out of their COP houses. Grocery giveaways. So each house has different programs going on within their neighborhoods.
You know, when did police cars, there are no more police cars on the streets. They're all police SUVs.
Yes.
When did police cars go? I just noticed that not too long ago. Somebody was saying to me, when was the last time you saw a police car? I said, there's one. He said, no, that's a police SUV. When was the last time you saw a police car? You know what? I can't remember.
Yeah, it's been a while, but we have more equipment that needs to be housed. Yeah. And
the other thing I got to ask is, and I watch some of these cop shows, it looks like they're walking around with 60 pounds worth of equipment, this utility vest they wear.
Yeah.
How do you even walk around with? How do you drive a car with that stuff on you?
Yeah, it's challenging, and over the years, it's not probably the healthiest for us. But the vests actually are healthier because it takes some of the weight off of the belt itself.
Do our police officers here have body cams?
Yes, all of our officers have a body cam.
You know, those are so helpful because people will say, well, I didn't do it.
Yes.
Yes, you did do it. We have, and the camera doesn't lie. You did do it. I like when they stop them and they say, you weren't wearing a seatbelt. Yes, I was wearing a seatbelt. No, you weren't. I have it on camera you weren't wearing a seatbelt, you liar. People can't tell the truth.
No.
They love lying to police. You want to hang in and have some fun here for a few minutes?
Sure.
All right, we're going to have some fun. Sergeant Kristi Wilcox is here from the Racine Police Department. Hang in there. We've got some, I think we have some tickets to give away to something in a few minutes. Yeah, we do. Wisconsin State Fair. Oh. And we also have some fun thing we're going to talk about here. Stay right where you are. 728, 729 now at WRJN. Hometown Radio Refreshed, a civic media station. Stay there. Song came out.
Right? I was actually, yes, I was.
Probably a little infant at the time. You don't remember?
No, quite infant.
Undercover Angel, Alan O'Day. I think he had one or two songs that made the charts. I was one of them. It's 7:35 at WRJN Radio. Sergeant Kristi Wilcox is here from the Racine Police Department. Let's get to some news here this morning, real quickly. The Racine County District Attorney's Office says it'll take up to 40 days to review the allegations regarding a campaign finance case. State Ethics Commissioner alleges collaboration between Donald Trump's Joint Fundraising Committee and GOP State Representative Janelle Brangen and others to circumvent campaign finance limits. Racine County District Attorney Patricia Hansen says in a statement she's reviewing the materials to determine if charges will be filed. It's alleged donations made to the Langlade County GOP were routed to the Steen campaign in a race against Robin Voss in Racine County. A Kenosha homeowner had some suspects hiding under their deck Saturday night. Police in Pleasant Prairie say two Illinois men are facing charges after an incident that started with a stolen car crashing into a village squad car. After a chase, the two men ran off and were found hiding under the deck at a home at 38th Avenue near 69th Street. Charges include fleeing and carrying a concealed weapon. We're talking about all these bad people. What they do? And they run like they're going to get away.
Right.
They don't get away. The Racine Zoo announced the passing of two of their animals, slender tail meerkats. Jack Clay and Arrow succumbed to age-related decline. Zoo officials say both meerkats lived past their species' normal life expectancy of 10 years, reaching the age of 15. And it's getting easier to become an officer. Gateway Technical College is offering a tuition-free part-time law enforcement Academy program. It's for those interested in law enforcement careers but unable to commit to full-time training due to time or financial constraints. The program is supported by a grant from the Wisconsin Technical College System and will cover tuition for up to 15 students. The story Stuart J. Waddles, our news director, is watching for us this morning in our news center. You guys have enough police officers, or is it tough to find them these days?
It's tough to find them. We're still short, but we're slowly gaining ground to get to our full strength.
There's no shortage of disc jockeys. We have plenty of them. If you need it, we can convert them over.
Sure, absolutely. We're hiring. We're always hiring.
Everybody wants to be a DJ. They think it's easy. It's not easy. It's tough. All right. Let's see what we got here this morning. You're not old enough to remember the Mickey Mouse Club. Maybe the second Mickey Mouse Club. There were two of them. The first ones back in the 50s. But
right, the black and white ones.
Then they had the 80s. They had the Mickey Mouse Club. And thanks to the Barbie song, I'm Just Ken, Ryan Gosling is now the 15th former member of the Mickey Mouse Club to make the Hot 100 charts.
Wow.
Can you name any of the others?
From the new one?
Yep.
Britney Spears.
Britney Spears.
Christina Aguilera.
Very good. That's two. One more.
Oh.
Justin Timberlake.
Oh, sure.
A lot of people don't realize that Britney Spears, Justin Timberlake, Christina Aguilera, and Ryan Gosling were all members of the Mickey Mouse Club.
Yeah.
Back in the day with the first batch, Annette Funicello.
Yes, she was the main one.
She had a lot of hit songs. And then there was Johnny Crawford. He was the on the TV show The Rifleman later on. He had a song. Paul Peterson. Now, Paul Peterson was on the Donna Reed show later on.
Okay.
He had a hit song called My Dad. Hmm. You don't remember that?
I don't not remember
My
that.
Dad, now there is a man. I remember that song. It pops up every Father's Day. Some radio station plays it. Maybe we will on Father's Day. Hmm. So anyway, yeah, Mickey Mouse Club. A lot of big people came from that show.
Yep.
I can remember the original Mickey Mouse Club people. I used to watch it in reruns. I don't remember it originally when it was on.
Yep.
But, Annette Funicello, she was the big one on that show.
She was the big one, yes, I remember her.
She was in a lot of movies, those ski party movies with Frankie Avalon.
Yep.
They were just terrible. But people went to go see them. The beach party.
Yeah.
With Frankie Avalon.
Yeah.
There's apparently a new scam where thieves are replacing QR codes on parking meters. Talked about this before. What they do is they put the QR codes, and people are pretty, you know, they just scan it, put their money in, and it goes to them, not the city. Kind of nasty, huh?
That is nasty.
All right, if you're a child of the 80s, you might have fun with this. MovieWeb.com put together a list of the best kids' movies of the 1980s. My daughter's is not... Oh, it is on the list. I didn't notice it the first time I read it. All right, these are the best kids' movies of the 80s. The Little Mermaid.
Yeah.
People love that one. Beetlejuice, which is coming out with a sequel. Beetlejuice 2. Yeah. Yeah. Beetlejuice, they're calling it. E.T. the Extraterrestrial.
Yeah.
Gremlins. It's got a cult following, that film.
Yeah.
The Karate Kid. Then they had The Karate Kid 2, 3, The New Karate Kid. And then they had that streaming series they have now.
Do they? I didn't realize
with Martin Cove is on it. He's from the original movie.
Hmm.
I forget what the name of that is. Then The Never Ending Story. That was my daughter's favorite movie growing up. The Never Ending Story. Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
And they've got another sequel coming out this summer.
That's right. They do.
Oh, all these there's nothing going to take the place of the original.
No.
My dad, he used to work in Manhattan, and one day this traffic, they was filming movies there. When they film movies, they generally do it on a Sunday because there's no traffic. But this particular day, it wasn't a Sunday, and they had traffic backed up all the way down. And when he finally got to the front of the line, he noticed there was a fake street built above the other streets, and the cars were into the fake street. It was built up about 6 or 8 feet, he said. And he said they're filming a movie. He didn't know what it was. It was Ghostbusters.
Oh.
And that's when the cars were going into the streets. And he said he used to hate that when they built those, all those stuff. Back to the Future.
Oh, yeah.
One of the biggest ones. They had two sequels. And after that, no more. And the Goonies. Now, there's one. I would have thought that the Breakfast Club would have been in there.
Yeah. Well, any of those. What was it? Pretty Pink,
Pretty in Pink. Right?
16 Candles.
Pretty in Pink, yeah.
Footloose was 40 years old.
Yeah,
just
Footloose
last
the
80s,
yeah. Yeah. Footloose from the 80s. The Last Dance, another one from the 80s.
Yep. Was Fame, was that a movie?
Fame, I think
that
Fame was a movie first, if it was a TV show. Interesting story about Flashdance, the people of Paramount shelved it. And the wife of the president of Paramount screened it. And she goes, oh, you have to release this film. And he said, no. It's got no story. It's got nothing to it. She goes, you have to release this film. And, of course, it was one of Paramount's biggest hits in the 80s, Flashdance. Yeah. So listen to the wife. don't, you know.
Exactly.
You know, sometimes guys don't know the answer to these things. The other one was Molly Ringwald, the pastor at my church, Spencer DeBerg, went to North Hollywood High. Molly Ringwald was in his class.
Oh, that's cool.
But a lot of famous actors were in his class because it was North Hollywood High.
Mm-hmm.
And Molly Ringwald. I said, did you know her? He said, yeah, I knew Molly Ringwald. I said, wow, okay. Yeah, so I always call him Pastor to the Stars because he knew all these people. Odd but true, freeze-dried astronaut ice cream was a real thing but never eaten by any astronauts in any mission. It never made it into space. Freeze-dried ice cream. Mm. Maybe they would have liked that. They tell you never use self-checkout. One criminal defense attorney says it's too risky. You can get falsely arrested for shoplifting, which can be a huge legal nightmare. You must still use, if you have to use it, he says, use it on small orders. Use your credit card for proof that you paid and get your receipt and go slowly so the cameras see everything you scan. I never use self-checkout.
I do all the time.
I hate it. I hate it because I know there's going to be a mistake. The one time I used it, I had to bring someone over. They had to reset. I had to rescan everything because it was a problem with the machine. I hate it. Hate it. I hope more people use it because that means the regular checkout lines will be shorter.
True.
More people like you.
Yeah.
Here's a strange crook. A guy from Georgia broke into a church in Florida to baptize himself. When he left the baptism, he robbed the place. People are so stupid. They're just so stupid. All right. Some of the biggest artists in the world never had a number one hit on the Billboard Hot 100 chart. The following people never hit number one. One Direction, the boy band. Mm-hmm. That I can believe. Shania Twain, oh. R.E.M., Metallica, Green Day, Pearl Jam, Bruce Springsteen. Now, Bruce Springsteen had a song that hit the number one position on the chart that he wrote, but it never no song by him. The Backstreet Boys never hit number one on the chart. Sheryl Crow and Imagine Dragons.
Huh.
Kind of
Shania
weird.
Twain.
Yeah.
That's surprising.
Never had a number one hit. Newest trend for brides is black wedding dresses. Hmm. Now, I used to watch this show called Say Yes to the Dress.
Yes,
remember
me
that
too.
Show?
Oh, yeah.
I used to watch it all the time. Because my wife watched it. That's what I'm going to tell you anyway. Excuse me. And they had people buying black dresses.
Yes.
And they looked like that girl from Beetlejuice who had a black wedding dress on.
Oh, no. I keep thinking Elvira, though.
Elvira, yeah. But, you know, a black wedding dress. Spokesperson for the chain David's Bridal says, just to have to custom order a black gown, but now they're so popular, they stock them. All the wedding dress colors trending right now, blue, purple, and red. I guess white is out, huh?
Well.
One of the first couples to get married, get married over Zoom. They're now divorcing. They still have never met in person. The woman says she never met her husband, and he was unfaithful. He's back with his ex now. Can't believe that didn't work out, huh?
Yeah, that's surprising.
Yeah, meet over Zoom, never meet, and get married over Zoom.
Never mind.
I gotta get a drink here. Hold on a second. A little dry.
Can you just get an annulment, I would think, in that situation, since it's not consummated?
I would just say it's not really a marriage.
Well, there's that too, but...
Oh, met over Zoom? Got married over Zoom? You got to be kidding me. Odd but true. If there were a hole going through the entire Earth and you fell into it, how long would it take you to get to the other side? I don't know how they figured this out, but they did. How long do you think it would take to go if there was a hole going right through to China?
And you're just free-falling?
Yep.
Oh.
It's not as long as you think. 38 minutes.
Oh, that's it?
Well, you're falling through a hole.
I mean, I get that.
But I don't know how you get through that center core that's all like lava and stuff. I mean, how do you get through that thing, that magma in the middle of the earth where all the volcano stuff comes from? Huh. I guess you have to get through that. You ever see one of those delivery robots they have now?
Yes.
Okay. If you've never encountered one, this person did. They photographed it. It was lost in the woods. Didn't know where to go. They just happened to spot it in the woods.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't think they perfected that AI stuff yet.
No.
I think we have to, I think we have some stuff to give away now. Let's do that. Oh. All right. Coming to the Wisconsin State Fair, Casting Crowns. They're a CCM group. That's a contemporary Christian music group. They're a powerhouse. They're coming to the State Fair main stage Monday, August 5th. You can join them for a fun-filled, powerful, soul-stirring artistry evening that will lift your spirit. Also joining Casting Crowns on the main stage, August 5th, is fellow CCM star Turin Wells. Tickets go on sale right now at wistatefair.com. And they're on sale all this week. And also all this week, I'm giving away tickets. If you want to win a pair before my voice totally leaves me this morning, give us a call at area code 262-634-9756. 262-634-WRJN, 262-634-9756. What a great phone number, huh? When they asked me when I came back here, they said, what kind of phone number do you want? I said, 634-WRJN, bring it back. Nobody took it.
Oh.
So we got it back.
There you go.
262-634-9756. First time I gave the phone number out, I gave the wrong phone number. And somebody, some poor soul was getting all these people calling. So anyway, if you want the tickets, give us a call right now. Phone lines are open, 262-634-9756. All right. All right. Sergeant Kristi Wilcox is here. We got a few more minutes left. And stay right where you are. Is here from the Racine Police Department. Give us a rundown in case people are just waking up now and just turning on the radio. Love Week.
Love Week.
He is coming up starting tomorrow. This is where the Racine Police Department shares the love all around Racine. We're spreading the love.
Spreading the love to every school in Racine Unified, even those outside of the city limits this year. It is to honor and surprise employees who can be described in one word, and that word is love. These employees' infectious, enthusiastic personalities are no secret to those around them, and so they are nominated, and there's a big presentation, and it's all a surprise to that employee. We partnered with educators this year who's donated $100 gift cards to Sebastian to each recipient, along with flowers from Unified, candy from Haribo, and certificates from the Racine Police Department.
Sharing the love. Whose idea was that?
Officer Travis Brady.
And that this started when?
This will be the second year. It started last year.
Okay.
Yep. So, he's a member of our community-oriented policing unit, and he runs out of the Anthony Lane COP house. There's six houses all together throughout the city.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, that's great.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Share the love. And these people don't even know they're going to win.
They do not know. Nope. They've been nominated by the people in their schools. I don't know how each has been nominated, but yep, they've been nominated. And we have all the names, and we show up within the next 3 days and present them with their stuff.
Get some good pictures of that. Put it online or something.
Yeah, I'll definitely do that.
And these people nominated?
Yep, it'll be on our Facebook and our Instagram.
Hopefully they won't be cheating on their vocabulary books like I was when I was nominated. You watch a lot of movies? You go to the movies a lot? Have you seen any of the Best Picture nominees?
No.
Okay, really? None of them?
Uh, No, yeah, because Barbie wasn't nominated. I did see Barbie.
He's nominated, Barbie.
Is it? I thought the director wasn't nominated. Correct.
Right, the director wasn't. Barbie's nominated for Best Picture.
Yes, I did see that.
You did?
I did.
How was it?
It was good. I went in and I didn't have any expectations, so.
I'm afraid to go into a theater to go see Barbie. I was afraid. You know, when I had my daughter, we used to go to daddy-daughter night. It took us to a million movies. And I used to see all these films, but I had my daughter with me, so.
So that was okay.
Yeah, I could say, well, I came with my daughter. I didn't want to see this picture. And I, you know, we saw some really terrible movies back in the 80s. The Smurfs and the Magic Flute and Here Come the Littles. All these horrible movies I had to sit through. They didn't have good movies like Barbie back then. But you said it was good, huh?
Yeah, it was good.
When we watch a movie at home, actors today tend to mumble. They don't. And the mumble through the lines like, you got to turn your subtitles. 66% of people say they turn their TV subtitles on when they're watching movies. They can't understand accents. They can't understand the mumbling from the actors. And we do that a lot at home. And it's not because we're getting old and we're hard of hearing. I mean, you can crank up the sound all you want to, but the mumbling. You can't understand the words you're saying like that. Somebody brought up something interesting. Godzilla Minus One is actually nominated for an Academy Award for nomination. Godzilla Minus One. And they said its prequel, Oppenheimer, is nominated for Best Picture. I thought that was really good. All right, here's a nice story for you. CNN did a story, speaking about Barbie, on a former fashion designer in New York named Barbara Lakin. She restores old Barbie dolls and makes clothing for them and then donates them to a place called the Little Shop of Kindness, where asylum seekers and immigrant families can shop for free.
Huh. That's very nice.
I've heard of doll hospitals where they restore these dolls and so forth. That's kind of nice to do something like that.
Yeah.
I wish I could do something nice for somebody. For the first time, America's credit card debt levels have surpassed $1 trillion. I wonder how much you contributed to that. All right. Olivia Newton-John, she's long gone. Supposedly has been appearing to family members as a blue orb, the same color as an aquamarine necklace she used to wear. Both her husband and her daughter, Chloe, say they have seen her in the orb.
Oh, interesting.
Who knows if that's really happening? Maybe people want to see that kind of stuff. All right, comedy albums. Do they make comedy albums anymore? I don't know. Richard Pryor's Live on the Sunset Strip was rated as the best comedy album of all time. George Carlin's Class Clown came in number two, then Bob Newhart's The Button-Down Mind of Bob Newhart at number three. My favorite were by Dennis Miller. This is before he became very political.
Sure.
I used to love listening to Dennis Miller. I got all his cassettes. I got his laser disc to show you how old it is. Odd but true, a woman in Detroit named Evelyn Overton found a recipe for cheesecake in the newspaper back in the 1940s. She started selling her cheesecake at a bakery in Los Angeles. Then her son turned that location into
Cheesecake Factory.
That's it. That's how it all began.
Wow.
So you live and learn it. You didn't know this stuff before you came in here this morning.
I did not.
Everybody walks in that door a little, you know, less smart.
Learn something new every day.
They leave a little smarter.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you're planning a wedding, a list of things people want retired from weddings included clinking silverware on the glasses to get the couple to kiss. You know, neighbors do that. The chicken dance.
Yeah.
I like the chicken dance at the over-drinking, which can lead to unwelcomed drama and distractions, and the couple smearing cake on each other's faces. They always do that. The top ways we help ourselves to wake up in the morning, drinking coffee. You drink coffee?
I do not.
I never had a cup in my life. Mm-mm. We have a coffee machine here. And I didn't know that. One of our guests came in and said, I wish you had a coffee machine. And every time she was in, she walked past the coffee machine. I said, how did you not notice it? She goes, you said you didn't have one. I said, but you passed it. And it's one of those ones where you put that little plastic thing in.
Sure, the Keurig or whatever.
That's it, yeah. I don't know how to work it, though. So if you want a cup of coffee, you're going to have to go get it on your own. And I get a scam call when I was talking to you. I just deleted it. The average American gets 26 scam calls a week, along with 11 unsolicited spam text messages. I get more than that. Do you get a lot?
I get a lot more on my work phone than I do my personal. But I do. I get more junk text messages.
I'm telling you, it's really bad. And I never answer them. And you can't get through to me if you're not on my phone list. You can't get through. But, I get them all the time, and I don't know how to stop them.
Is there no call list?
Well, there's supposed to be $5,000 every time you do it, and you're not supposed to do it. Real quickly here, before we leave, I got to mention this here. Hospice Alliance, they collaborate with their patients and their loved ones on goals, seeking to add more life to days. The Hospice Alliance team helps people with life-limiting illnesses live each day with dignity, comfort, and hope. When seeking hospice care, ask for Hospice Alliance, the award-winning community-based nonprofit that gives back through education, services, and grief support. To learn more, visit hospicealliance.org. That's hospicealliance.org. Sergeant Kristi Wilcox, thank you for staying in here this morning.
Thanks for having me this morning.
Yeah, I love when people come in here and share, so I'm not alone in the room here. And Love Week starts?
Tomorrow.
Love Week. All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
Be safe there.
Thank you. You too.
Say the Hill Street Blues. Be safe out there. All right.